A lot of good things come in pairs. For example, having a pair of dogs in your home is sure to make every day brighter and full of wagging tails. It's twice the cuddling, twice the barking, and twice the antics. When Taryn and Jenna Choquette say they have two dogs, however, they're not being entirely accurate. It might seem like they do, but truthfully, their golden retriever, Brady, is the only legitimate pup in the house. You'd forgive the Choquettes for forgetting this, however. The root of this traces back to the day they found a little kitten clinging to a tree in an Austin, Texas neighborhood. The real confusion, however, started when they brought that kitten home. After a friend of a friend discovered a tiny stray kitten clinging to a tree in an Austin, Texas neighborhood, Taryn and Jenna Choquette knew they had to help the little guy. What they couldn't have predicted, however, was what would happen when they brought him home. The kitten, whom they named Chuka, took to the couple and their comfortable home right away. He was the perfect fit, but they worried how he and their golden retriever Brady would get along. Cats and dogs historically don't see eye to eye. From the moment the two were introduced, however, it was obvious there was a connection that Taryn and Jenna couldn't quite comprehend. Brady was extremely curious about the little kitten, while Chuka was quite anxious of his new dog friend. So, as to not overwhelm the tiny kitten, Taryn and Jenna decided to keep him in a separate room for a period of time, though Brady would sleep outside Tuka's door anyway. Luckily, he began to warm up to his adoptive brother. Brady loves all creatures, great and small, Taryn happily explained in an interview. He wants everyone and everything to be his best friend. That was good news for Tuka, who certainly needed help coming out of his shell. Brady sure sounded like the right pooch for the job. Not long after they were allowed to interact further, the two became almost inseparable. What had started with some trepidation on Tuka's part had evolved into a full-blown love fest. He completely adored his big brother. Brady, meanwhile, had taken on a role as Tuka's foster mom, and he truly seemed to relish that position. He didn't even mind when little Tuka, who wasn't fully weaned when he was found, actually tried to suckle on Brady. From there, Brady just kept trying to teach the tiny kitten how to go about an average day. The only issue was that Brady only knew how to teach Tuka how to be a dog, and hilariously, that's exactly what happened. Brady would also show Tuka how to drink water from his own bowl, Taryn pointed out. To this day, Tuka will not drink bowl out of a tiny cat bowl. He only drinks out of Brady's giant water bowl. We're sure actually standing in the bowl was Tuka's own improvisation, however. As Tuka grew older and matured physically, he lost the gray spot on his head, but not the love for his big brother. Brady was careful to teach Tuka how to chew on grass in their backyard and how to put on cute puppy dog eyes when begging for food. Tuka picked up on these lessons with ease. Truly, he was an excellent protege. We always joke that Tuka is more like Brady, more of a dog than a cat, Taryn explained. So we just call them the dogs. Cat or dog, Tuka sure learned how to beg for leftover food from his humans pretty quickly, huh? The two were also huge fans of playing, especially of the roughhousing variety. When they got going, they sure looked like a pair of dogs. It was easy to see why Tuka grew up with an adorable sense of mistaken identity. Every morning when I get ready for work, they chase each other around the house, Taryn said. Tuka likes to launch off the wall to get a head start, and Brady is kind of giant and cumbersome, and he'll chase him around, and they'll jump on the bed and wrestle forever. They'll always do it late at night when I'm trying to sleep or wake me up in the morning. Word is they even enjoyed teaming up for some mischief. Their favorite game so far involved having Tuka knock food and other snacks off the counter so Brady could mop it up below. They're in cahoots, Taryn joked. Tuka was such a big fan of Brady that whenever the neighbor's dog, Wyatt, came over to play with them, the kitten would try to scare him off. He just did not like the idea of sharing his best buddy's attention with anyone else. Tuka is very protective of Brady, Taryn went on to explain. He growls like a dog, and he actually sounds like a dog. It's so funny. It certainly sounded like someone got straight A's on their How to Dog 101 class, huh? The cutest thing was if Brady ever had to leave for any period of time. When that happened, Tuka was known to mope about the house. Once his doggy pal came home, however, he was sure to never leave his friend's side. Ever. Whenever we come back, Brady lies down and Tuka sniffs all around like tell me where you've been. Tell me all the things that you've done, said Taryn. That sounded exactly like what a dog would do for any human. I think he thinks he's just like Brady, Taryn ultimately concluded. He's actually never met another cat, so I think he assumes he's a dog, just like Brady's brother. Since he was adopted, it made a lot of sense why Tuca would behave that way. These two made for a perfect doggy duo, for sure. Aren't these two the absolute best? There's just something about a cat thinking he's a dog that makes everything okay. Now, if only every pet could have this kind of friendship with other furry members of the house. Share these adorable pals with your friends.